Oh, my dear. Our love is here to stay. Together we going on a long, long way.
Prior to America's involvement in World War II, the young couple, who would later be known as Bob and Hattie Marion, met and fell in love.
When we was growing up as teenagers and in school, we met along a roadside one day. I was on my way to the mill taking corn to be ground. He wanted to come to my house, so he came to my house. I gave him a haircut. I cut his hair. And from that on, we decided that we would be friends, you know, boyfriends and girlfriends. So later, he was drafted into the Army.
Following the war, some American servicemen, like Gerald Ashenbremer, found their true love waiting just behind enemy lines. Former German Air Force servicewoman Wilma Kasich was waiting in line at the theater when her future husband, Gerald, gathered up the nerve to say hello.
The war pretty well ended, and those guys were stationed down the street from where I lived. When I met Jerry, my sergeant, my girlfriend, we were going to the movie, and we heard those click, click, click behind us. And she said, Wilma, I think there are some GIs behind us.
And they were talking, we listened, and of course I could understand German quite a bit. And
so he said, Wohin gehst du, Fräulein? And she said, don't you dare talk to him.
I asked her if she would take me out someplace around the city. She said, yes, she would.
I told her to wait till I served my time and then we could marry. I was MP. General Patton was our general.
I was in combat in the 26th Infantry Division, 10 Charlie Company.
I was drafted. Yeah, I was in the German Air Force. We had to send messages to the artillery, watching out for the enemy airplanes at that time. We got messages when the planes started crossing the channel. We already knew they were coming, and we already got prepared for it.
His mother and my mother, they knew each other. We all farmed on the farm down in Mississippi. He would write me long, long letters. He was asking me, was I waiting for him? So I would write back to him and say, yes, I'm waiting for you.
I remember lots of nights I would almost go to sleep on my feet. We'd have to keep the front line safe with ammunition, gasoline, and ration. And then we'd also have to go back and clean up the dead. And we would bring them to the cemetery and bury them. And they got so bad till the enemy would plant mines and booby traps up under the dead bodies. And you'd see that body going up, blowing up. And didn't know whether I'd be living the next minute or not.
As far as fighting is concerned in Germany, it wasn't too good. I remember one time that we settled down in one particular house, and I thought that we were going to stay in that house for a short time. I got a fire started and put some potatoes on the stove, and no more started on cooking the potatoes, and zoom, come a shell into our house, and a bazooka round came into that building, hit the other side, and exploded. And, well, I'm here today and my buddy is not.
When he was at war, I would think about him so much that I would go and visit the veteran hospital and see some of the soldiers and things in there. It was really a sad sight to see. They didn't talk too much about what had happened to him. Well, what they were really interested in is getting well.
Planes returned after they dropped the bombs. They crossed the channel again, going back west. Then we got to relax again and waiting for the next attack. We saw the bombs drop, and we've seen a lot of heartache and a lot of dead bodies.
The idea of love and marriage seemed like an impossible dream for men and women serving on the front lines of battle or waiting on the home front as the death toll numbers continued to rise.
It was German cemetery on this side, American cemetery on this side, and our pup tent was pitched right between them. It'd be sometime the head be blowed off, arm. They was all dead when we picked them up. It was something.
I can truly say that there were some German families, at least two different ones, that we came in contact in the maneuvering across Germany. And one time they told us not go towards our right, go to the left, because the Germans had their artillery and such over that way. So I consider that German civilians actually saved our lives.
And because these wartime couples kept their hopes and dreams alive, love survived.
I never gave up. I never did. 3 years, I waited.
Mm-hmm. And we got married January the 13th in 46.
And this is the thing I kept for all these 60 some years. It had sweetheart, my sweetheart on it, hold it up.
I bought this in
Durham, North Carolina was
it? Yeah.
My mother and father didn't know that I was dating the enemy.
She told me to not come upstairs because her dad would beat me. I said, well, I wasn't afraid of him or anybody else. I'm going to keep her till the end.
Yeah, we're doing pretty good. I get a little sassy now and then, you know how that is.